Hey, what's up? This is Mikey at Blue Monkey Bicycles, and in this video, we're going to take a look at the Brose S mid-drive motor. Well, I got the picture. If you have a Brose mid-drive motor or any other mid-drive motor, don't take it off the bike and try to fiddle with it. All the electrical and mechanical warranty work should be done by a competent professional, such as the place that you got the bike from in the first place, so don't go voiding the warranty and risking injury or damaging the bike by pulling it off. Oh, and by the way, this just happens to be a regular Brose motor. It's not a Brose S. I don't have one in hand that I can actually show you quite yet, but nonetheless, it's a good illustration, so let's jump in. Brose is an electric motor manufacturer based out of Germany that has been making electric motors for quite a while, but it wasn't until recently that they came into the US with the Brose mid-drive system for electric bikes. Now, Brose doesn't really have a household name the way that Yamaha, Bosch, or Shimano. However, they still compete head-to-head because their mid-drive system has a super secret power. It's a belt drive. I first caught wind of the Brose system just before the American debut a couple years ago. Back then, I got a sneak peek at the Easy Motion Atom bikes featuring the regular Brose motor, not the Brose S, and we'll get into that in a second. On account of the motor, it was super smooth and super quiet, and it provided plenty of torque. I was very excited. We tried it out on the trails here in Utah, and it was quite a hoot. Among its competitors, the Brose system is easily the smoothest and quietest. Quietest?
Good one.
The internal belt is the key to its performance. The belt mitigates the noise and friction of a metal-to-metal gear or a metal-to-composite gear, and it puts a lot of class into the entire experience. The Brose S sports some really good specs. The Brose S is still a 250-watt nominal rating, but it assists up to 380% and supports up to 120 RPMs, and it rocks 90 newton meters of torque. The Brose S looks amazing on paper. Mechanically, the motor has a spindle length of 150 millimeters, and the whole thing weighs in at 3.4 kilograms. It has physical dimensions of 8.4 inches long, 5 inches tall, and 4.6 inches wide, without the spindle on that one. Other extra features include a dual freewheel on the motor and a double water-sealed internal system that offers a little more peace of mind. One bike that really shines is the Pedigo Conveyor. It's a belt drive. Get it? Conveyor, belt, drive. Anyways, it rocks the Brose S system, which of course has the internal belt drive, but it also, as a bicycle, has a belt drive for the mechanical gearing as well. Smoother than Steve McQueen sliding down a baby beluga's buttery back. You can get the Pedigo Conveyor from BlueMonkeyBicycles.com and enjoy other exclusive Blue Monkey benefits, such as an assembly video, how to use a display, and a whole lot more. Anyways, let's get back to the motor. Now, where other motor manufacturers have an entire system with it, Brose doesn't really seem to mind all that much. There's a lot of bicycle companies that are using just the Brose motor and then using their own display or their own battery to make a complete electric bike system. Even the same bike company using the same Brose motor may have different displays or batteries. As a matter of fact, some of the bicycles rocking the Brose system have smartphone integration, but I'm pretty sure that's a thing that came from the bicycle company. It's kind of hard to tell. The lines start getting blurry at some point. In an upcoming video, I'm going to be comparing the specifications of the Brose S motor alongside of its newer competitors, the Yamaha PWX and the Shimano E8000, along with the Bosch CX motor that I don't have in hand. So yeah, stay tuned for that upcoming video. After that, I'm actually going to put rubber to the road and try out bicycles that have these systems equipped, and I'll be able to give you some firsthand experience. Other than that, let me know what else you'd like to see on the channel, and I will see you guys on the later.